proceedings. You're still standing. Good to see.
Still standing.
Summation of the Victorian Riesling tasting.
I was unprepared for what was in front of me. I made the massive mistake of painting with a broad brush what all Aussie Rieslings are going through. It blew my mind, and I would say in all of my years of Riesling thinking, that I've truly never been to a tasting like this. I saw a style of Riesling that I would have thought was only old world, German of nature, in its power and its depth, and its roundness, and its compression. It wasn't a big fat over the top. There was this compressed energy in the mouth that literally scared the crap out of me. In addition, we talk about one of the great things of Riesling being longevity. Like, we had a 1971 Australian Riesling today, and it tasted like it was 10 years old, not 4 years old. From my neck of the woods, I would never have thought that was possible. And so many other things in between then and the present vintage, extraordinary across the board. We need these wines in America.